So the riders line up for the 125cc Grand Prix of Indonesia. Here at Sentul, Jorge Martinez Aspar lines up on pole position as well. Your front row, Martinez, Monaco, Sakata and Rossi, the world champion on the outside.
Valentino Rossi, 10 wins already this season, looking for number 11. Gensanti, Tokodom, McCoy and Locatelli make up your second row here.
Yuichi Wee, Scalvini, Nobby Wader and Maturana on the third row.
And our fourth row is head off by Maseo Azuma, Petit, Gino Borsoi and Cheryl Yuzi in 16.
It's almost like a home Grand Prix, this one, for Yuzi, the Malaysian rider. Cecchinello, Geisler, Jenkner and Kato.
Sada, Yaroslav Hules, Dirk Rowdies and Angel Nieto Jr. on number 24 at the end of the sixth row.
Soler, Jayadi, Arianto and Octavianus. Make up row 7. A couple of local Indonesian riders there just bring up the rear of the grid. Ahmed Jayadi and Irvin Octavianus. Incredible name, that, I think.
Fortunately, he's not too far front of the track, so we won't be seeing that much of him. But there seems to be a problem with one of the bikes.
Just couldn't quite see who that was on row 2. All the riders look round, see what goes on, but they get away enough for the warm-up lap.
The two UGT bikes sitting there in second and third position.
Rossi enjoying himself on the warm-up lap with a bit of a wheelie.
Well, he's already world champion, he can afford to do that.
Yeah, he can go around and enjoy it here. Still going for that record number of victories. He's equaled Fausto Grassini's 10 wins in a season. Looking for number 11 here. It's been a brilliant year from the 18-year-old Italian. Of course, crowned back at Brno.
And as they just file round on this warm-up lap, the Sentul circuit. Here, very hot out there at the moment. Very high track temperatures, but nothing new for Indonesia.
Riders always have to suffer with the humidity and the heat here. Take as much water on beforehand. Do everything they can to keep cool on the bikes as well.
Big field we've got here for this 125cc race. And it's definitely going to be quite tight as we head down into the first corner on the first lap. And see there, the grid starting to form up now.
Yeah, it's Martinez who starts from pole position. He'll be hoping to pick up his first victory of the year. Still searching for it. Former world champion, of course. So 26 laps of the Sentul track. Red flag being shown. There's Martinez, Aspar as he's better known. Lights go on. And on comes the green, away they go. Not such a great start from Martinez, actually, from that front row.
And it looks like it's Sakata who got the best start. Rossi on the outside of the front row, not so good, but it's Sakata, because it's Sakata who leads into turn one. The others all pushing in behind him, and it does look Aspar, like Martinez is up into second place. Yep. And then it is Monaco in third, ahead of Rossi.
So Sakata gets the whole shot. Being trailed now by Aspar. Looks like a mover though. It's Monaco coming through on the inside of Aspar, goes through into second position. Rossi just in fourth place, the new world champion.
Mirko Gensanti is actually just been passed by Rossi, number 32 Gensanti. He had a great start and he's now in fifth position. Rossi in fourth, but it is the Japanese rider who is leading way out in the front. Kazuto Sakata, the man who was a former world champion and currently sitting fourth in the championship at the moment, is leading the way here today. Leading it quite comfortably from the start. His teammate, Monaco, behind in the number 3.
Rossi's making moves and through he goes on Martinez, up into third position now from Valentino Rossi. You can just see Gensanti just tucked in behind Martinez as the rest file through. A huge field, as we said. They come now down into the final corner. Long right-hander. And that will bring them back into the start-finish straight. So, leading across the start-finish line for the first time, it's Sakata from Monaco. Then it's Rossi Then just in behind is Martinez. Just following him is Mirko Giansanti. Azuma, Uwe, Nobby Wader down in eighth position. Second
Rossi
in the
moving
championship,
up to second there. Just as we look down, Rossi moves up into second in the start finish straight.
McCoy, Locatelli, Scalvini, Petit, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th. Then Cecchinello, Borsoi, Sada and Tocodomi. Well, he's dropped right down the order, hasn't he, Tocodomi? Down into 16th, a shocking start for the Japanese rider.
Rossi is really making himself felt. He's closed right up on Sakata now. And he's right on the back wheel, and he split the two UGT bikes. And Martinez is just holding on in fourth position at the moment, but these four already have made a slight gap on the rest of the field, and Rossi now closing right up on Sakata. He got a good run through there, but won't be close enough to make a move for the lead just yet.
Yeah, there's a slight gap back in there. It looks like Giansanti's dropped out of it somewhat. He's not there to be seen at the moment. He just dropped back a couple of positions, I think. His front four try and escape from the rest. He's disappeared, hasn't he? For
here comes Rossi. Here comes Rossi right through on the inside of Sakata. Very nice move there by Valentino Rossi in the chicane. Just stuck that bike up the inside, carried a bit more corner speed, and it's through into the lead. This is ominous. The speed and the ease with which he's carved his way from fifth to first in just under a lap, really.
Yeah, he's shown that talent all season, Valentino Rossi.
Just a little wave there to Sakata. Not sure if that was sorry for a hard move or just follow me and we'll clear out. Because Rossi definitely seems to have some pace at the moment. Sakata, though, is not. I think maybe he thought that hand was to say, just come back past me, because he is back through into the lead now.
Mirko Giansanti has reclaimed fifth from Nobby Wader. If you can guarantee Ueda will be fighting to get back in front of him, trying to get back amongst this front group. Of course, Ueda currently second in the standings behind Valentino Rossi. Rossi at the front. Under pressure still from Sakata. I have to say, it's two world champions at the front now. Or three, of course, with Jorge Martinez just in behind as well.
This circuit is probably better for the 125s than it is for either the 250s or the 500s. The straights are just long enough in the 125s to really make use of the slipstream. There's no real challenging long technical corners here. There's a lot of flip-flop chicanes and the occasional faster chicane, but it's all about getting a nice draft on these bikes. You can see it's always right to left. They do. Let's have a look at the second group at the moment. That is Yuichi Ui leading that group, number 41.
On board the Yamaha, Yuichi Ui, but at the front it's an Aprilia leading another Aprilia, Rossi from Sakata. And in fact, Jorge Martinez also on Aprilia in third position as well. Just behind him, though, the first of the Hondas, and that's Tsumomi Monaco. You can see those two involved in their own little battle at the moment. But Rossi and Sakata are the ones trying to get away at the front. Comes under pressure now, Rossi from Sakata. He has a think about going up on the inside after three laps of 26.
That second group, Ui, Ueda, Scalvini and Giansanti. Mirko Giansanti there. Ueda is the man who's currently the closest challenger to Valentino Rossi, but he's struggling at the moment. They're quite a way back from these leaders. Rossi now in second place. He's lost out to Sakata just off camera.
That's good that he's got back in front. Should make a race of it now, Sakata. A big look behind there from Jorge Martinez.
He knows there's a big gap there now.
Yeah,
I mean,
he just should be racing, shouldn't he, with Monaco at the moment. Trying to get back, really, to this front too. Sakata has hit the front, though. So he's up to Rossi to find a way past him once more.
Sakata looking over his shoulder as well. They're just not really sure about who they're fighting with at the moment and where everybody is, but hopefully those couple of little looks over. Now they know that we've got a two and a two here, and Rossi really is riding the wheels off that bike. He's putting it everywhere he needs to, and looks like he can easily keep pace with Sakata as the Japanese rider continues to lead on his Aprilia, his teammate in fourth position, riding a Honda, obviously. Look at the speed that Valentino Rossi carried there, just completely round the outside of Sakata. That was a wonderful move by the newly crowned world champion in the 125cc class. And completing another lap, that's lap four down. Monaco and Martinez losing out a little bit more on that lap. Ueda still has now finally got past Yuichi Ui, in fact. So Noboru Ueda starting to make a run of it. Masaki Tokodome at the back of that group. We're expecting more from him this weekend, but it's never really quite gelled for the Aprilia rider.
So Scarter and Rossi lead us through. Not too much distance between them and the third and fourth place riders, but it is starting to spread out at the front. This head-to-head battle between these two, who over the last couple of years have enjoyed some good battles at the front, haven't they? Now Rossi is the world champion. He's taken over that mantle. And he goes through once the Carlson shows him once more why. Martinez in third position. And in fourth place is Monaco. Then you see that third group of Ueda, Yuichi Wei, Gianluigi Scalvini, Mirko Giansanti, and Petit as well, Frédéric Petit, also involved in that group.
And despite the fact that the two leading riders are fighting amongst each other, they're still managing to keep, or it's even slightly increased the gap to third and fourth place, who in turn have pulled 4 seconds or so on the third place gap now.
There's Nobby Ueda coming through in fifth position at the moment, just in front of Yuichi Wei and Gianluigi Scalvini as well, just behind him. You can see they're a long, long way back, almost the length of the straight behind Rossi, who's again trying to pull away from Scarta at the front. And then Martinez and Monaco come through, the battle for the final podium position, but still quite a way to go. However, if Rossi keeps pulling away at the front, very hard to see someone getting back in front of him apart from Scarta in this position. Martinez really tucking under the bubble of that bike. Martinez are number five there, Monaco number three.
The Spanish rider absolutely trying to get as much of his body behind the protection of the wind bullet as possible. Once again, takes a look back, but all he will see is that one rider behind him in the shape of Monaco, and then a big gap. 4 seconds or more. It's now up to 4.5 seconds over the fifth placed riders. So Valentino Rossi continuing to lead here and really stretching this field. He's blowing them away, considering we're only on lap five. The young Italian, new world champion, really showing these guys how it's done. Perhaps he's just got the perfect tire choice, though. These guys are all running very similar compounds here.
Surely in these kind of conditions, it's as hard as you can
go. Yeah, pretty much, I think so.
With the heat out, they won't get too much choice in the 125s, but they'll probably be going with the hardest thing, what they've got. There's the battle raging for fifth position. Scalvini in the middle of the two Japanese riders, Ueda and Ui.
Yeah, he's got past Ui in that last off-camera, last half lap. Ui riding the Yamaha, chasing the two Honda riders down the long straight here. Trying to stay in touch, the bike definitely doesn't seem to quite have the pace of the Hondas, and there goes Scalvini.
Tokodome there, it's just in behind them as well.
Yeah, Scalvini's just going to hold on to this, but not quite. He runs it deep. And Ueda just cannot get quite past him at the end. The Yamaha Kurzrider is going to make a serious benefit out of this because he got a great drive and will also pass Ueda going into this final corner. No, not quite. Ueda just late enough on the brakes to defend that position. Sixth place for Ueda then, behind Gianluigi Scalvini. This is where the fight is at the moment. The front really has quietened down after those opening few laps. Such is the pace of Valentino Rossi.
Scalvini number 21, Nobby Ueda number 7, Yuichi Wei number 41 as well. There's Tokodome going through, Petit as well, coming through on the pitch. Also Gary McCoy is in there as well.
Seems that Tokodome has made a starting to come good in this race out of the number two, running the Dock Shop Aprilia. And he had a pretty poor start, but he's starting to make some ground now. He should be with these guys within the next couple of laps for sure, but there's still a fight going on, and Ueda wants to get back ahead of Scalvini, and I'm sure he will do very soon. Scalvini, they're both running slightly different front-end setups at the moment. Scalvini's reverted to a twin-disc setup for this race, which is slightly different to the other riders. You can see most of them run a single disc up the front, but he's obviously decided that he needs a bit more braking power, and it's showing to be good at the moment. He's having a good race there, but now it's starting to spread out. Third place for Jorge Martinez Aspar. Tomomi Monaco in fourth place. He's lost touch slightly with him now, but back with our leader. Setting a fastest lap of the race, 1:34 for Valentino Rossi. Really stretching this field to the limit at the moment, and Looking back at over his shoulder, he's wondering, why isn't anybody following me?
Well, he's just taking his time at the moment. Really difficult conditions out there for concentration for the riders. Scorching temperatures, high humidity as well. Not so much maybe on the 125, certainly as you get the bigger bike as well. There's a lot of heat being kicked out by the machines too. And you see the gap between Rossi and Scarta now nearly at 2 seconds as well. So he looks very, very comfortable, doesn't he, Valentino Rossi? Incredible season last year, of course. And then this year has really just dominated things. 10 victories already to his name. This could be an 11th victory, a new record for the 125cc World Championship.
Not if he carries on riding like that, because he's having a few moments out there.
A couple of moments
still
there.
Pushing very hard.
I think that seems to me about Rossi. It's the only thing he knows. Just push hard.
Yeah.
Push hard as possible. He just knows how to go fast. Now you can see he's just pulled out another 7/10 of a second just in that final section of track there. 8 laps down of 26. Rossi from Sakata, Martinez and Monaco. Then it's Ueda, Scalvini, Uwe and Tokodomi.
And what did I say? Here comes
right
Tokodomi.
Back into it, hasn't
he? He has. He's really caught up to the back of them, and he was actually challenging Yuichui there for the back of that group. I don't know whether he got past. In fact, he didn't quite.
He's just in front of him, but he just shows in 125. Nothing's ever over, is it, in a race? And we see Rossi way out in front. But things can change. You know, tyres could go. Could have problems later on in the race. If he's pushing too hard, might have a few issues later on. Valentino Rossi, Nobby Ueda, he knows his way around this track well.
These guys have got a way to go if they want to catch up to the front four, or even the back end of the front four. But I'm still hopeful that something could come of this. They're driving each other on at the moment. Yui now getting up.
Pascal Vini. Up into seventh position.
They are slowly catching Monaco, actually. Down to 3.6 seconds, the gap down from just over 4. So they are slowly catching him. Ueda is driving the pace of this second group now. And well, he should, because he's currently sitting second in the championship and he will probably finish there. There's nothing he can do about Valentino Rossi now, but he has been the closest challenger to Rossi all the way through the year. And this race isn't a fair reflection of his talents aboard that Honda. So if anybody can drag them up, it will be him.
Yeah, just the middle part of the season being the problem for Nobby Ueda. Rossi extending his lead even further. It's comfortable now ahead of Sakata. Another big gap of more than 3 seconds back to Martinez and another 3 seconds back to Monaco. So the front four are spread out by 9 seconds between them. And not much action going on, so this is why we're watching Tokodomi try and work on his compatriot, Yuichi Wee, the Italian Scalvini, and another Japanese rider, Noboru Ueda.
So you've got two Hondas, a Yamaha and an Aprilia. Ueda riding the Honda, Scalvini on the Honda, Yui riding the 41 blue Yamaha Team Kurtz Yamaha bike.
Just in the top of the picture there as well, you can see Gary McCoy coming through, just with Petit for company as well. McCoy, the Australian, pushing hard to get involved in this, get involved in the top end, really, isn't he?
So these guys, 3 seconds back from fourth place at the moment. Slowly reeling them in, though. Little bit by little bit. There's still a long way to go in this race.
The thing that they seem to be doing is working together here, and that's what they have to do. If they battle amongst each other and they keep chopping and changing positions all the time, there's no way they'll catch up to Monaco.
For any of these guys, fifth position isn't the result that they're looking for.
No.
They want better. They want to get up on the podium, and they know that the only way to do that is to slowly bring back, and they can see that little bit by little bit they're catching the people in front of them. As long as they're not being caught by the guys behind, they're okay. A four-rider battle is probably about enough for them, I would say. But as I say that, Tokodomi moves past Yui under power.
And Scalvini goes past
on Ueda. No, quite though, Ueda, I think, has a defensive line. Yeah.
I'm sure it was just...
It was showing him a wheel, I think, saying, come on, here's the hurry up. So Ueda still leading this. Scalvini in just behind him, not in second place. This is the battle for fifth position. And sixth position now goes to Masaki Tokodomi. So Tokodomi has obviously got some pace. He thinks he can pull this race up, raise their game, and take them up to challenge for fourth position.
Yep, still leading the race, Valentino Rossi from Sakata. Martinez in third spot. Monaco in fourth still, but they are closing in on Monaco, so he shouldn't consider himself that he's going to hold on. You can see visibly a lot closer there. You just see Monaco went through on the shot. There he is. Yeah. It was 3 seconds, but that's under 3 seconds now, definitely.
Perhaps the heat getting to the riders already in this race. You wouldn't think that tire durability this far on, this soon on, would be an issue. Perhaps he's just struggling in the conditions out there. Tropical conditions, high humidity, as well as a strong, strong sunshine. Back. Our leader's already out of shot. Rossi and well through Sakata.
He's now
nearly 6 seconds behind Indin. Martinez actually has closed the gap slightly on Sakata. It's down to just over 2 seconds.
Really has spaced out somewhat this race now. And there is Sakata on board that UGT machine. World champion, of course, a couple of seasons ago. Arashiki Aoki, of course, stepping up to the 250cc category.
Once again, a long look over his shoulder for Aspar. Jorge Martinez, he's now pretty much clear in third position and closing slightly.
Yeah, he is definitely closing in, the Spaniard, isn't he, on Sakata. I think his presence felt.
Sakata knows it now.
Yeah,
I
he just
think.
Looked over his shoulder then, and we've just seen that white number five on the red bike of Martinez. And now just the Spaniard just needs to plug away, slowly but surely, close in.
It's always easier to chase than it is to lead.
Definitely, and as soon as it gets within this sort of distance, you know that there's someone within touching distance, know that there is a chance for you to get up there.
Looking at fourth place now, Tomomi Monaco. He had a good look on long look over his shoulder there at the group chasing behind him. And it definitely is chasing and starting to close on the Japanese rider. But nobody is closing on this man. Valentino Rossi is in imperious form at the moment.
Yeah, could be on course to take Grassini's 10 race or 10 wins in a season. He's already had 10. This could be his number 11th, as we've said. It's been a brilliant, brilliant second season from the young Italian. Of course, already crowned world champion back in the Czech Republic. And now 7 seconds separate him from the 94 world champion Sakata. Not too much between Sakata and the 88 world champion, Jorge Martinez.
Sakata did put up that fight earlier on in the race, but really couldn't quite stick it to the young Italian as he would hope to, or stay with him. And now he has to fight off the attentions of Aspar, who really is closing on him quite considerably at the moment, really gaining on him.
Yep, and Scarta's looked again, hasn't he, on that very same corner, just knowing that the Spaniard is closing down on him. So Japanese rider, I think, just needs to focus on his own race at the moment.
Yeah, I'm not sure if he's managing his own race so much as just trying, you know, trying to stay ahead. It doesn't look like he's holding the gap as well as he should. He should be more in control than he is, but he's looking over his shoulder perhaps too much for my liking. Here is our main battle. It is Nobby Ueda who is leading it. Yuichi on the Yamaha, the lead Yamaha rider just behind him, closing up on him, and these guys in turn gaining on the number three bike of Monaco. Scalvini behind them has dropped a little bit. We've got 2 and 2. Scalvini has dropped off. From behind them.
The distance between Monaco and these guys behind is closing all the time.
There
the goes through, yeah.
And Tokodrome as well went through on Scalvini. So,
but we haven't seen it again. We haven't seen what we might expect from Tokodrome. He started much higher up the grid and a shocking start to the race. We actually expected a bit more from him this season.
He hasn't really gelled with this year's Aprilia.
Yeah, last year, much, much better performance, of course.
But he will be back, that is for sure. Very, very fast rider on his day, but sometimes that day just doesn't happen enough. Yuichi now. He will be someone to look for over the next few years. He's definitely riding the wheels off that Yamaha, which we know is definitely not as good a 125cc racing machine as either the Honda or the Aprilia motorcycles. And he's pushing it hard here.
The Austrian engineer Harold Barthol works on those bikes. Back in Austria, really trying to get as much out of them as possible. And they have struggled. There aren't as many Yamahas out there as there are Hondas and Aprilias. But Luis put up a good performance here and is, let's say, starting to just pull away slightly from Ueda. Ueda would completely disagree with that statement. He's got it all under control. Scalvini just dropping off, isn't he? Just slightly off the back of Tokodomi there. Still Rossi leads. Now the gap back to Sakata is at 8 seconds. Martinez almost within a second now of Sakata.
Yeah, so that magic second is the key for them. If you can get inside that, then he can really get the hooks in and close in very, very quickly. It's something we've seen a lot, especially in 125cc racing. Once you're inside that distance on a track like this, he's starting to think about getting the toe, but one man who did get the toe was
Nobby Wader.
Nobby Wader.
They say I was completely fooled there. I said
he proved it. He showed that he
had a bit of a moment though, coming out the corner. Sorry. Had to wave to Yuichi Weeks. He was up in the saddle and sat up there.
Tokodomi is sitting up. I'm not sure what's going on there, but he sat up mid straight, which was a bit of a strange one.
Maybe his bike's over revving or something over. Just trying to slow it down slightly and just trying to get some more air into it going down the straight.
We'll see how he does here. He's looking behind him, but maybe he was just looking behind him before as well. And just over accentuated the movement.
So this is Nobby Ueda, number 7, ahead of Yuichi Wee, two Japanese riders, chasing another Japanese rider in Tomomi Monaco.
Monaco really has come back to them, and they've gained on him as we head towards the final third of this race. Number 3, Monaco, really having some issues now and dropping back in the clutch of these four, and he could lose quite a lot of positions once he gets through there, because they're all closing on him. They're all running a much higher pace, though they are benefiting from the slipstream. UE left and then right and takes the inside line and nicely through on Ueda. 11 laps to go here in the Indonesian Grand Prix. And it will be 11 tense laps for these guys.
Wader straight back in front of Yuichi Wee.
See what I mean? The Yamaha is just not quite as quick.
It's true. He just doesn't have the edge, does he? There at all. And
went to blunt
edge. Wader was very, very, very easy the way he went past him there. But you have to say, Monaco is right in their sights now.
Yeah, Monaco riding the Honda teammate to Sakata, who's currently running second at the moment in this Grand Prix. Ueda now just slightly ahead of UE and closing right up. These guys will be on the back of.
But it's through these sections where we have these the flip-flop S's that UE does close right up, isn't it?
Yeah.
Does carry that good corner pace, but unfortunately for him, just on the exit of the corners and just when we have the longer sections of track, just loses out on power. Monaco then, you see his hair trailing out the back of his helmet, currently sitting in fourth place.
Love to know what his pit board says. It's going to have been creeping down and down and down on the gap, and that can't do anything for your nerves, especially when there's 10 laps to go in the race. It's going to be very, very difficult for him to hold on, especially as we see there, Tokodomi was starting to make a move and looking fairly racy. Now he's closed right on the back of UGE. So we've got four Japanese riders, one Italian rider, fighting for fourth position this is. At the moment, Monaco leads the way.
But only for fourth.
Only for fourth, yeah.
You've got to remember, we have Valentino Rossi right out in front of this
miles
race.
In the distance,
a
actually.
Long, long way ahead. Then Sakata is behind him, but at the moment it's about 9 seconds, the gap between the Italian and the Japanese former world champion. And then
very slow through there was the number Monaco. 3 bike, Monaco. He really, really was losing a lot of time on the entry into corners. So maybe he's suffering some real front tire
problems.
Issues. Yeah,
it looks like it, doesn't it? And
pushing, I know, slid. You see it there. The front tire just went away from him. He saved it on the way in. He's not looking happy with the front end of that motorcycle. That is going to be a big problem, because if he gets past, he's going to have to come back past on the power. He won't be able to outbrake anybody, I don't think, at the moment. Not the way with that bike is behaving on the brakes. So it seems to be just a matter of time before he starts to go fully backwards and is swallowed by this pack. And Nobby Ueda looking for fourth position. And may well get it now. They're weaving and bobbing in the slipstream. This front straight is very, very long for a 1-2-5. And Ueda does get it. And so does Tokodome. Tokodome passes Yui. Ueda passes Monaco and takes fourth position. So our first major change of position in the top four since early on in this race. Lap 17 of 26. Looking further down the order, McCoy in ninth. Petit, Azuma in 11th. Not a great ride from Maceo Azuma ahead of Roberto Locatelli. And now here we go.
You just saw in that graphic as well, Valentino Rossi has 8 seconds on Gesuto Sakata. The gap between himself and Martinez has just gone out to 1.5 seconds. So although Martinez had been closing, it seems Sakata has just found something now, and their pace has leveled and not making too much of an impression, the Spaniard, on the Japanese rider.
Watch out for Tokodome. He's really starting to look like he's going to make a move. At the moment, he's fanning out widely as they come into the hard-breaking zones. Long look over his shoulder for Azuma. Not on Azuma, sorry. For Ueda, number 7 bike. Didn't seem to slow him down going into there, though. But these guys are really bunched up again now. Now that they've caught Monaco, this battle is 5 bikes deep.
Yep, Scalvini just at the back of this pack. Hasn't had much to say in it, but he'll be thinking about fourth position. You can guarantee that.
He's got quite a lot of thinking to do, though. Yeah. He's going to make it up there. He's got 4 riders
worth
of thinking
to do. He's got some riding to do as well as they come back down the home straight more time.
Let's
there's Sakata going through. Martinez just in behind him. This is the battle of fourth place. Remember, Valentino Rossi out at front. And here comes Monaco looking on the inside of Ueda. You can see Scalvini now has done some thinking. He's got through on
Yuichi. Good bit of thinking.
Great thinking there from Scalvini.
He used his Honda Thought Power to get past the Yamaha Thought Power there
into on the straight. Spot. But again, the Yamaha, as we know, is probably slightly down on power and probably suffering at this part of the race. Meanwhile, not suffering is Monaco, who goes back through and past Nobby Ueda. That should be a nice little battle there between these guys.
Yeah, to everybody having a look back.
Again, Tokodome having a sit-up.
Yeah, it was a long look back of his shoulder. It wasn't a look under his arm. It was a big, I know you're there. Well, I do now. And he's going to make a move. He does. Tokodome goes.
He looked so far over his shoulder, he forgot to brake in that corner. Goes through. And claims the position from Nobby Ueda. So Tokodome reclaims another position.
There is our leader.
In this race.
Our leader. You may have thought we were cutting to a completely different circuit there. Yeah. How far ahead Valentino Rossi is, but no, that is the leader of the race, and he's still being chased by Sakata.
Yeah, I'm sure Rossi now will be seeing his pit board and be thinking, right, I can take this easy pretty much from here on in. But he's got to just be careful, keep his concentration with the conditions out there. Very easy to lose concentration as well. Very easy to lose your focus. It's high temperatures, high humidity. Starting to feel it at this part of the race. You can see Rossi's already gone through turn one now. 7.3 seconds. So Sakata has taken, on the last couple of laps, about a second out of Valentino Rossi's
pack. Wait, how far did Tokodome go out there? But he made it. He made it up into fourth position. He took two riders there. Sorry, one rider in the end. But he was right over next to pit wall. Very, very wide line into turn one. Well, tight line, actually, in the end.
Just a shot
this
there.
This is a replay of one rider at the back of the field running straight on through the gravel. Federico Petit running the Honda.
He had been going quite well, Petit, hadn't he? Been up there with McCoy and Locatelli in that back for 9th and 10th position, but unfortunately runs it wide, and that will cost him valuable positions in this race for the Frenchman.
In the meantime, though, it's
Ueda
who's got back in front of Tokodome. And we missed that whilst we're looking at the replay, but he's definitely Tokodome once again looking over his shoulder. I think he needs to worry about who's in front of him. He looked over both shoulders then. I'm not entirely sure what's going on.
You never know what side the rider's going to be on coming past you. But I'd rather personally, concentrate on what's going on in
front. But it's long straights here. I guess they've got time to do it.
Yeah.
At the moment, it's a, you know, they're spending a lot of time just completely pinned in sixth gear. So
I think he needs a rear view mirrors fitted, doesn't
yeah.
he?
Yeah, to the side of his helmet, possibly.
There's Valentino Rossi comfortably leading this race. Now, he had a look over at the pit board, so I think that any gap that Zaccardi is pulling back is due to Rossi just easing up slightly.
Yeah.
On course for an 11th victory of the season. Six laps, or just under six laps remaining now for the Italian.
32 is, that's
Gian Santi,
who we saw earlier. And we wondered what had happened to him, but he's obviously having some serious either tire or mechanical issues, and he's about to be lapped.
He's run off track or anything like that, or...
He was looking over his shoulder there, and you can see the blue flag being waved any second now as the man he was racing with early on in this race. He's definitely sitting up. He's not racing at the moment.
I just wonder if he has had some kind
on.
Of mechanical problem there, John.
We lost him from the front group early on, disappointingly. And now he's been passed and lapped. Had a lap put on him by Valentino Rossi, which is disappointing. Gian Santi there. Rossi getting rid of a tear-off, or perhaps waving at his friend. It's hard to tell from that distance, but there
you can see.
Is
this is how the gaps have gone between Rossi and Zaccardi. Was at 8.3, came down to about 8, now at 7.6.
He's so really managing the gap. It's
gap,
gone
yeah.
down and up a little bit, but it's just, it's not really showing anything about the Zaccardi closing the gap. And the gap, again, Zaccardi to Aspar is staying pretty steady as well.
So about Valentino Rossi now, on course for his 11th victory of the season. Will move up to the 250cc class next year with Aprilia as well. And he's certainly going to set the cat amongst the pigeons, I'm sure, when
he'll
be joining the quarter lead.
Joining
class.
Harada and Caparossi, riding for the Works Aprilia team. That will be quite a fierce battle, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Depending on how quickly Valentino Rossi adapts to the bike, though. Some people manage it, some people don't, but you'd hope that he can get a handle on it fairly quickly.
He's certainly got pace, certainly knows how to go fast, and that's the main thing. Jorge Martinez, we know he knows how to go fast. Multi-world champion, of course, in the 80cc, winner in 125 back in 1988 as well, right in the twilight of his career now. Could be the end of Jorge Martinez this year. Seen retiring, going into team management, of course, already runs this team. The Airtel setup. Really, I love the way he tucks right underneath the bubble. Yeah,
it's head down.
Bubble.
It doesn't actually look like he's looking forwards at the moment. He's got his head right down into the into underneath the bubble, looking down at the electronic, the instruments there. And he doesn't really need to look where he's going on the straight, to be honest, anyway, here. Such is the nature of this central track. The battle is still going on behind
him. That wasn't Rossi, was it? I saw a bright yellow flash go from by the
may well have been the helmet of Gian Santi.
Yeah, well, I'd think so, and I'd hope so.
Unless Rossi has had a problem.
No,
there's definitely no bike in front of Zaccardi at the moment.
That's Zaccardi in second then. Martinez in third position. And, at the moment, it's a bit of an Aprilia parade, isn't it? Rossi from Zaccardi, from Martinez, all of them on the Italian machines. Martinez really willing that bike along.
Okay, and behind them, it does look still to be Ueda.
Ueda, yeah. Four laps remaining, though, when they cross the start-finish line now. Nobby Ueda currently hanging on to
and
fourth position.
You and
oh, Takadomi, though, comes through. And Takadomi goes up into fifth. But I think maybe coming round, I thought that Yuichi Wee, yeah, well, he has.
Yes, Yuichi's got past both of them.
Up into fourth position.
Scalavini has dropped off the back a little bit. Ueda, both of them fanning out either side of the Yamaha. He's going to get swamped, and is, by an Aprilia and a Honda Takadomi. Yui just holds on, keeping Ueda behind him, but Takadomi takes that fourth position back. These guys are just swamping the poor Yamaha on the straight. Yuichi Wee doesn't stand a chance unless he can stay in the slipstream. So what thoughts are going through his head at the moment? If we look back, that is the gap from third place back to fourth place in real time. Takadomi, Ueda.
So there you can see Monaco as well at the back, and Scalvini just unable to do anything. He's got that yellow, bright yellow helmet on his bike there. And you can see the gap is nearly 6 seconds between Martinez and Takadomi, so no real hope of the podium here unless something dramatic happens at the front.
something dramatic will definitely happen here. These guys, if they all make it to the end of the race in one piece without maybe a broken fairing, then I'll be very surprised.
You might be very gentlemen off track, all these Japanese riders, but when they get on track, they're not shy about making a few rash manoeuvres.
Three laps to go here now. And what will we see from these guys? Once again, Yuichi drops back and he'll lose another place. Indeed, he does. Monaco goes back inside. Monaco is definitely not finished here. But what can he do about the slightly faster Honda and Aprilia ahead of him?
Yeah, they are looking like they're ready to swap a bit of paint here and there as Ueda goes through and up into fourth position. Just see them all lining up there going, right, I'm going to get stuck into this one now. See if we can claim this fourth position. Sakata's obviously given up the ghost on getting Rossi, but he's done enough to keep Martinez well at bay, hasn't he?
Yeah, and this won't harm his championship challenge at the moment. He's been a good runner all year and is looking for a solid, at least fourth place, maybe even with a shout of third in the championship. Jorge Martinez has brought to his friends and to most people, actually, sitting in third place. Former 125cc world champion. So is this man, Sakata. Both of them chasing the man who's won this year's championship, Valentino Rossi, and is going for his 11th win of the season to take a new record in the 125cc class for number of wins in a championship year. Behind them, the battle is still raging. You can see at the top of the screen there, Rossi passes in front of us at the bottom, as at the back end of the screen. With two laps to go, riders sitting up once more, Monaco sitting up.
Yeah, they, I just think that's the battle we need to be seeing at the moment, but we're not. We're seeing Valentino Rossi go through, then that's Sakata. The gap is definitely closing, but surely it's just Rossi letting up more than anything. This is the battle we want to see, the one for fourth, because there's going to be some fairing bashing going on here. We're going to see a classic end to for these 1-2-5.
Scalvini's got past Yuichi as well. Yuichi seems to be right at the back of this group now, so maybe his hopes are done with a lap and a half to go.
Yeah, he's had to struggle all race with that Yamaha. We've seen him a few times down on power slightly, having to make everything up in the corners. There's your man who's in a different class today. You have to say Valentino Rossi. And Takatomi.
Defensive line, I think, really more than anything. He's worried about Scalvini behind him.
He just spread out. Ueda not going to be under any pressure at the moment, is he? From Monaco just in behind him. He's just doing enough.
So we've got four Japanese riders and one Italian here. Ueda from Monaco. Sorry, the number two is Monaco. Number three.
Valentino Rossi then comes into the home straight. One more time, and leg gets dangled out by Valentino Rossi.
No. There's one more lap, Valentino.
Does he think the race is over?
Oh, no, he's still taking that corner at some pace. I think he's just...
He's loving this one, Valentino Rossi. On the last lap of the race, he's still going for it, but knows he's won and going around waving to the fans in the crowd. Great stuff.
He's got
5.7 seconds
worth of celebration to do on this lap in a two-minute lap, so I think he could do it. But these guys won't be celebrating. If they do, then they are really stupid and they're not going to do it as they weave and dodge. Now, this is when it matters. It doesn't matter how many people you've passed before, but it does
Monaco
now.
Monaco goes through on Nobby Ueda and up into fourth position.
Great move by Monaco. He's back into that position that he held for so long in this race. But he's now vulnerable to a slipstream from behind him, and it will be Ueda. Desperately trying to get inside, and as Ueda moves back through into fourth.
Well, I've never seen do anything like Valentino Rossi was just doing. Never seen a rider do that before, celebrating a whole lap before the end of the race.
Normally it's maybe one corner, two corners if you're lucky.
Here comes Takatomi just having a look on the inside of Monaco, and he does go through, but he runs it wide on the exit, and Monaco will be able to come back in front of him. So Ueda hangs on to fourth. Just in behind him is Monaco, yes, just, and then Takatomi, then Scalvini, and then Ueda. And here comes Valentino Rossi.
Is that the right
into
straight?
Into the final
it
corner.
Is.
And Valentino Rossi celebrates victory in 11th win of the season for Valentino Rossi. A new record in the 125cc class. The world champion wins in Indonesia. Just in behind him is Kazuto Sakata. As they come across the line then, Martinez third, Ueda fourth, Monaco fifth.
Dancing Takedomi across sixth. The line for Valentino Rossi.
So Luigi Scalvini, fair ride from him in seventh. Yuichi Ui couldn't do anything by the end of that race. And, well,
Monaco very disappointed there to end up with fifth position after holding fourth for so long, slapping the tank. But great race from those guys in the end, and a bit more dancing from Valentino Rossi. I think he's quite happy about that one.
Yeah, would you think so? And the 11th victory of the season. That's been an impressive, impressive season from the 18-year-old. We're already crowned world champion, of course.
Yeah, 125 season that we won't see matched for a long time, I think. Nor will you be able to wheelie like that on a 125 for a long time. Great bike control, always has had, always will have natural ability in Valentino Rossi. Gangly teenager. Kadizes got it in second place.
No, it was Martinez, yep, he came over. In his first podium, really, since the French Grand Prix earlier on, sorry, the Italian Grand Prix earlier on this season. Good to see him back on there, but it really is the end of Jorge Martinez's career. Valentino Rossi.
Clapping with his feet.
Do you think he's happy? Do you think he's enjoyed that victory?
No, I think he's been practicing these techniques.
Confirmation then of the standings. Rossi wins from Kazuto Sakata in second position. Martinez in third. Three world champions standing on top of the podium here in Indonesia. And Nobby Ueda wins out in that fearsome battle for fourth position. McCoy, Locatelli, Azuma, Borsoi, Cecchinello. Petit manages to take points despite running off into the gravel. And Stevie Jenkner just takes the final points position just ahead of Angel Nieto Jr. And you can see he's enjoying this and doing some kind of, I think it was the birdie song, something like that there for Valentino Rossi. You can see he broke the circuit record as well in this race, a 134.044. The pole was Martinez, but he could only manage third position in the race.
Rossi seems to have missed the
entry to pit lane.
Well, he's the podium's further up, so... He's going back in, or maybe he's just going straight off to the party. These are our podium then. Rossi, Sakata, and Jorge Martinez.
There's the championship as it stands. One more round to come. 311 to Valentino Rossi. Nobby Ueda in second with 213. Monaco, Sakata, Martinez moves up into fifth spot with that finish today. Takedomi in sixth, Gary McCoy in seventh, and Roberto Locatelli down in eighth. But of course, the man who was crowned world champion, Valentino Rossi, back at the Czech Republic, victorious in a very, very dominant fashion today. He was celebrating with over a lap remaining in the race, so it just shows how impressive he was.
The rest of the championship, Petit on 83 points ahead of Yuichi Ui, who we saw quite a lot of today. Mirko Giansanti, 11th position. Kato Scalvini, only 13th. Despite a strong showing today. So here is our race winner,
Valentino Rossi.
This is him crossing the line. Nastro Azzurro Aprilia, number 46, a number that has already become synonymous with him. Rossi Fumi winning his 11th Grand Prix of the year, setting a new record as we see Jorge Martinez Aspar mounting the podium for third position. Indonesian Grand Prix 1997. Spaniard, Japanese, and Italian taking your top three.
Getting some water on board there as well, because it's not very nice conditions out there. Very humid, very hot. Sakata steps on in second position. Shake of the hands between the two former world champions. But it's the new world champion, Valentino Rossi, who will take top spot
with ice tucked down the back of his neck to keep him cool. It is hot out there.
Dan berkenan saudara sekalian, ketua umum KONI. Pada saat ini Pak Wismoyo akan menyampaikan salam lebih dahulu sebagaimana diatur oleh panitia-panitia kejuaraan Marlboro dunia ini.
Waiting for the Italian national anthem. Right, he's going to receive his trophies first, of course.
Martinez, number 32nd. That is to be Sakata.
Jorge Martinez then picks up the trophy for third position.
appears to be two blocks of gold.
And the shake of the hand there from Valentino Rossi as well. And then he picks up his trophy. Rossi has the winner. And Giampiero Sacchi collects the team award as well. And the Italian national anthem rings out around Central. Valentino Rossi, rather than listening to the anthem, more interested in talking to Sakata about that race there.
Saying, where were you?
Where were you? Why weren't you alongside me?
I wasn't going fast.